Hello and welcome to the WCHS Today Show. I'm your co-host, Mark Kerr. Tonight we're going to have a special feature on Kevin Jarbo. We have several clips and we've also got gigantosurgeons, as they call themselves. Now let's have a warm welcome for your host, John Wall.
Hi, Mark. How are you doing? Good week?
Just okay week.
Okay. Let's go over and see the gigantosurgeons here. We have outfits on the gigantosurgeons. Let's have a little modeling show here. Very nice. Very nice. All right. What songs do you have for us tonight?
The song of Bob.
The Song of Bob. Okay, but we're not going to hear that now. We'll hear that later, right? Okay. All right. Well, we'll get back to the gigantosurgeons. Gigantosurgeons. We'll start the show, as we always will, always have, with the weekly top 10 presented by Andy Berger. Alright, and the topic this week?
Topic this week is the top 10 things said while we were trying to make up this top 10. Alright, number 10. Do we have to do this again? Number
Very
nine.
Popular answer.
Yeah, right. Number nine. Get an idiot sign, Chris, and wear it. Number eight. What the heck should we name this week's top 10?
Number eight.
Number seven. What is a gigantosurgeon anyway? Speaking of the gigantosurgeons, I must say you look very nice in your new outfits. You look.
Yeah.
Don't egg them on.
All right. Number six on this wonderful top 10 is, should we get mushroom or pepperoni?
I definitely heard that.
Number five.
Yeah.
Number four. Number four is, put your clothes back on, Mark. All right. Number three is that creamy Italian or Thousand Island? Number two. All right.
Control yourself, Mark.
Number two is, let's finish the top 10, guys. And number one is, the number one thing we said while making up this top 10 is, what in the heck is Woody's job anyway?
The weekly top 10. All those things were actually said, believe you me. We have sports correspondents, as usual, are Rich, Doring, and Kara Jos. But tonight it'll be just Kara Jos presenting our sports correspondents.
Hello.
And what about the sports world?
A lot went on last week. Sophomores played last Monday against Canton. And
this would be football?
Yeah, football, sophomores, sorry. And they
Quite
won.
Quite a few sophomore teams.
And they won. And they play again. Oh, they won 35-7.
All right. Yeah.
And they play Morton this Monday. And then we have tennis, and they played Manual last time they played, and then varsity lost, unfortunately, but the JV did win.
Now this is women's tennis happens in the
spring.
In the fall,
in
and
the fall,
men's is in the spring.
In the spring, yeah.
Obviously.
Okay, and then they play Woodruff next Monday. Okay, and soccer, varsity soccer and JV, they played Streeter, And Varsity lost. And
I surprise. Just don't know.
And JV won. And so that's good. They've got a pretty good season record this year. Their record is 3-3-2, I think. And then Tuesday they play Metamora. And in varsity football, everybody's favorite, we played Canton last Friday, as everybody knows, and we won 28-0.
Yeah! Right. Yeah!
And we had the touchdowns. Ty Foster had two, real big surprise. He had a lot of them. Then John Sponsor had one, and then Jay Gaday had one too.
What that Sponsor touchdown, a beautiful pass into the end zone. Mm-hmm. That was very nice. Was nice to see.
Okay, and then they play in Morton away tomorrow. That'll be Friday. Play Morton. Okay, and golf, they won.
Yeah!
There's golf players out there.
Some golf.
What is it with all these people not at practice tonight?
They won from Limestone last time they played. And they're playing IBC Thursday, which would be today. And those people out there aren't there. And then finally, cross country, which is this fall. They played Canton. Well, they ran against Canton and they won. And then they play Pekin today, Thursday.
Pretty strong on our running.
Yeah, we don't have, there's not a lot of people there, but they're good, the people that are there.
Okay, what do we have to look forward to in the coming weeks? Homecoming game,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah, homecoming game next Saturday against East Peoria. I don't know.
Just lots of stuff, right?
Yeah, lots of stuff. Lots of homecoming stuff next week. Sports and stuff.
Okay, well, thanks a lot. Come back next week. Okay. Sports correspondent.
Yes!
All right, come to the time in our show with our featured guest. And tonight, our featured guest is Kevin Jarbo, fellow classmate, sophomore this year, who was vacationing with his family in Sioux City, I think it's North Carolina, when he suffered a stroke and remained there for a few weeks and just recently brought back to Peoria at Methodist. And first of all, we have, courtesy of Channel 31, we have a news clip to show you that they had on, if we could show that.
A sudden accident or illness could change your life dramatically, confining you to a wheelchair or leaving you unable to speak. But there is help. A special institute here in Peoria that works towards rehabilitation is drawing patients from all over the state. Paige Parrish tells us more in this week's Medical Extra.
Kevin, he has a signal here. His finger up is yes, and then a fist. Show him no, Kevin. And then
15-year-old Kevin Jarbo uses signals and a computer with a voice to communicate after suffering a stroke while on vacation with his family this summer. Physical, occupational, and speech therapists from Peoria's Institute of Physical Medicine and Rehabilitation are just a few of the people working with Kevin to return his body to the way it was. The stroke did not affect Kevin's mind. Number one in his class at Washington High School, Kevin now has a very different and vigorous daily routine.
So by 4:30, when he's all done, he's beat. Just like working, he said it's harder than football. You know, he was out for football before this happened. He said it's harder than football, isn't it, Kevin? So this is the hardest thing he's ever done.
The Institute's patients range in age from infants to senior citizens.
All right, and then like I said, that was we thank Channel 31 for that. And as they said, the stroke impaired Kevin's voluntary muscle control and preventing such activities as speaking and walking. And like they said, how greatly his mind was not affected, which is very nice. And he speaks by way of a computer board. He uses his finger to point out different words. And so he can have visitors that he can communicate with. Now, the town of Washington can be really proud that we've really rallied around this and helped out a lot in raising money for the Kevin Jarbo Medical Fund. Is that what it's named? Which at the Washington State Bank. What type of fundraisers have there been? There's been a car wash sponsored by our very own Key Club here at the high school, which raised a good deal of money.
Over $450.
Over $450. And also St. Pat's Church, well, and also the community. That was a number of groups involved with that. Had a pancake and sausage breakfast, which raised $7,000, which helped pay for his plane ride back and also that computer he uses to speak with. And they had a very nice article about Kevin in the Journal Star. I don't think the picture, I don't know if that's really good enough to get in there. And quite a lengthy article, really nice, very nice about Kevin. And we ourselves made a video from some pictures that Mrs. Jarbo let us use, and it's quite a nice video, and we have to thank some people down at Channel 32, Dan Bigger, and a group of us put this video together, if we could see that now.
I can't remember when you were there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down. You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I've found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. I've loved the life we've made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you through the years. I can't remember what I used to do, who I trusted, who I listened to before. I swear you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone so. But through the years it seems to me I need you more and more. Through the years, through all the good and bad, I know how much we have. I've always been so glad to be with you. As long as it's okay, I'll stay with you through the years. Through the years when everything went wrong, together we were strong. I know
someone so young, but we miss you and we anxiously await your return to Washington. All right, we bring on our arts correspondents next, and that would be Chris Franklin and Barb Tarkowski. Okay, what about the world of fine arts at Waco High?
Well, the band did great last Sunday at the Dwight competition. The band placed first in the parade in horn line, auxiliary, percussion, and overall.
All right.
And in field, they won first in horn line, auxiliary, and percussion. So they did really good.
job.
Yeah.
Okay, and in the world of our vocal music, well, number one, we're sorry to say, but the company will not be performing at the Homecoming Carnival this year, but we don't have enough time, so. But we will be performing for our fall concert on October 21st at 3 o'clock, and the Prep Chorus, Concert Choir, and Company will be performing then. So everybody come. Okay? So?
That's in the West Gym, by the way.
Okay.
Now, where's the band going to be this Saturday? Busy band.
Pekin.
Pekin for the, is that the Marigold Festival?
No, just Pekin Field.
No, just Pekin
Field.
I don't know. We didn't
Braden
go,
Field.
So I,
it's
or did we go?
Braden Field.
Yeah. Did we go to the Marigold? Okay, we're in the Marigold Parade already. All right. And this is just Pekin band.
In field competition.
Parade and field. So, hey, if you're not doing anything this Saturday, go support the band. Anything else to come up recent? Other than the concert choir game at the carnival, which will be the Name That Tune contest. Be sure and catch that.
Starring Tony Robbins.
Yes, starring Tony Robbins and I will be judging myself, and that'll be a wonderful contest. Anything else you can add? A way of drama or?
We're in the midst of choosing our fall play. It hasn't been picked yet, so we'll be announcing that as soon as we know.
It's mostly still homecoming activities right now.
Yeah, homecoming activities.
So it's really going to take a few weeks to get underway.
Right.
Yep.
Okay, well, come back next week to the homecoming show and tell us about it.
Okay.
Thanks, Barb. Okay, it's time for the Gigantosurgeons special. What tune do we have? With the original, the Bob song.
The Song of Bob.
The Song of Bob. Let's hear it, Gigantosurgeons. Composed and arranged completely by themselves. Very nice.
Improvisation.
Total improvisation, all right. Will we see the Gigantosurgeons next week at the homecoming show, or that's still a maybe not? That's a maybe, maybe not, but hopefully. It's a tentative date, so. Let's have a little audience game now. We need a little audience participation. So, to select our lucky TV Club members, I have a bowl of everyone's name who is here, and Mark will select some names to ask some questions. You got the questions there. You can keep the questions. Okay, you got one. All right. And the number, I'll have to look at my
six.
Trusty sheet, wherever I put that.
Well, John, you've lost your trusty sheet.
Oh, no, here it is. Okay. Number six, that would be Kara Jones. Kara will be a contestant. Come on down.
Number 20.
And that is Tom Valencik. All right.
It's rigged.
And the name of this game is Illinois Facts. Rules of this game here. Mark will ask the question, and if you think you know the answer, just raise your hand as fast as you can.
What do we win?
And the winner gets bag popcorn.
Bag popcorn.
Just as I knew they would.
Yes. Okay.
All right. The first question.
First question is, from what country were pheasants introduced into Illinois? Tom.
China.
China is correct.
All right, yeah. Woo! Okay, that's score one for Tom and Karen to nothing.
Okay.
Rigged.
What?
What?
China and pheasants, that is not very
getting
tough.
I'm weird. I know all this stupid stuff, okay?
Okay, question number two. What is the largest man-made earthwork in the world? Huh.
I believe that's Cahokia Mounds, and I think the center mound's like 100 feet wide and 1,000 feet long.
Oh, that's a correct answer. That's two for good.
Good turn. Very nice, Tom. Very nice.
I know this.
Tom.
What's the answer to the next question?
I have no idea.
Question. Next question. Forget what number.
Three.
Question number three. What story of a young girl and her dog Sandy was Tom?
That's Little Orphan Annie. Sandy and dog. I know that. I watched the movie. Got a little sister.
Is that a threat? That's a correct answer. That's correct. Score three, Tom, and Kara's got the goose egg here. So two more questions left.
Okay. What writer was born in Galesburg and won the Pulitzer Prize?
Oh,
Kara.
Oh, and that'll
See,
be
it's
a
not
3-1.
It's not fixed. That's
3-1. Tom's in the lead with the final question.
The final question, okay. The final question is actually an answer. I give the answer, you give the question. Okay.
We have to phrase it in the form of question.
Yes, I think so.
Yes,
and this one you don't have to raise your hand. This is kind of like the end of a popular game show where you just think about it and then tell us.
Like the bonus round.
Yeah, bonus round here.
Dave, and the answer is Lincoln.
Who is the president of the United States that was born in Illinois?
Wrong. He was born in Kentucky.
I'm sorry.
Lincoln. Oh. I believe it's the town that Abraham Lincoln christened with the juice of a watermelon.
That is correct.
Oh,
let's hear it for Tom, the winner of Illinois.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh, nice try. Nice try.
Nice. Good job, Tom. Your knowledge.
Thank our contestants. I don't see how you could say it was rigged when it was a final score of 5-1. You know, she got a question.
She got one.
Maybe we'll bring back, like, Kentucky facts or something next week. I don't know.
Maybe forget one of those.
Who knows? We go now to our special video segment of the evening where we look back at a past year. And this would be we're still in the Jim Tallman years. And this was a show, Jim Tallman and his crew were absolute masters with creating these special video clips. And it is about golf. So we'll just go to that now. The golf video.
Oh,
this is where we got out of control a little bit here.
Here was the best shot of the day, man. I did have the best shot, the one closest to a hole in one. Our cameraman did pick this up, which is pretty nice work by Shane and the man.
Oh, no.
Form.
Oh, no.
Beautiful, watch this.
No.
Holy cow. Whoa, it's still going. It's slowing down. And watch this. Just missed. Oh. Oh. And that was a day at the golf course.
The most unbelievable shot ever, Jim.
What a shot there. Okay, I bet you can all tell me what is next.
And
audience poll, we go to the celebrated school box, pencil box. It has the question was for this week, why hasn't our varsity soccer team won a game yet? I think we have a record of 10-0 or something like that. But anyway, 0-10, sorry. The team bought pacifiers and can't dribble. Woody finally grew hair, so they had to get a new ball. The underworld has not frozen over yet. Because Pele frowns on all extracurricular activities except sumo wrestling. Whatever. Juan Valdez retired. Yeah, because Rich Doering is not a part of it this year. Because Kevin graduated and Rich isn't playing this year. They don't know how to play. Well, I wouldn't say that. Rich Doering, the internationally famous soccer player, gave it up to be in more school activities, such as WCHS today. Because Barb Teven frowns on extracurricular activities. Excuse me. Sick, peep. Yeah, and we will publish these unread answers, which are just hilarious but inappropriate. Because Rich Doering, Dave Aiken, Rich Doering, Mark Kerr, and Rich Doering aren't playing.
Something on your drawing. Rich never did play. I mean, even when he was on the team.
They don't have Mark Kerr there to kick some butt. I think that's a. That is definitely. Yeah. Whatever. The team lost their pep when the polka band left.
Did somebody say polka?
Because Mark, Dave, and Rich. And Rich, Dave, and Mark, and Rich aren't playing on the team anymore.
Sounds of silence.
They need mental help, because Rich Doering isn't on the team anymore.
Sounds like Doug
Shirt. Yeah. Because Juan Valdez and his donkey Pepe are sidelined for steroid use. Oh, now here's a good answer. Because they don't have a large enough group of spectators to cheer them
Andy?
On.
Right, yeah.
Andy is, I think, our sole soccer fan. Because they stink as always. No, that's not true.
Right when Rich, Dave, and Mark won.
They don't have enough fans at the games. That's true. They have no spectator support. Because Scott Whitledge is one of the leaders. What? Now I think your sister wrote that, Scott.
In the audience, yeah.
Because Pat Kenny is hurt. I don't know what happened. Because Leapfrog 2 isn't playing varsity.
Yes!
No, they didn't sleep wrong too.
Because they stink.
Yeah.
Whatever. Their coach, Elvis, has not shown up yet.
He's dead.
He's dead.
No, he's not. I saw him in Kmart yesterday.
Answer.
He's a man decomposing.
Because they're just awful. Now leave them alone. I just don't know. Very, very depressing. Depressing answers. The poll was decent. Yeah, well, cheer on your soccer team, and maybe if all of us showed up at the game, they would be so overwhelmed. They would score so many goals, and we would win. So,
maybe.
Okay, a little music, a little bit of some. All right. That's quite all right. Okay, as we said, you know, we like to dedicate this show to Kevin Jarboe, and we do wait anxiously for him to come back to school. And we will see you next week for the homecoming extravaganza.
Yeah. Yeah.
Next week. Same time, same channel. Thanks a lot.
Oh.